Salut tout le monde, j'espère que vous allez très bien. Bonne année l'argent, bonne année santé. Happy New Year to everyone. I hope everyone is doing really, really, really great. I hope your year started off on a good note. I know I've been away for some time, just been busy. After I came from Kenya, I had to sort out some things. Welcome to my very first video of 2020. If you're new to my channel, please feel free to hit the subscribe button somewhere here. And also don't forget to hit that notification button so that you know when I upload my videos. Welcome back to my usual subscribers. Thank you so much for supporting me in 2019. So lately I've been talking to a lot of people that are planning to come to Abidjan this year, and I figured why not give everyone a couple of tips that will help you just to pack and to know what to bring to Abidjan if this is going to be your first time here. These are some of the things that I wish I knew before I came here, so I really hope it's going to be of help. If I forget something, just write it down in the comment section below and it will be of use to someone else. So the very first thing is you need to carry your own travel adapter. Here in Abidjan, we use a different kind of like socket and electric plugs. They're all like two-pinned and round to avoid any inconvenience, especially let's say you've come here for a conference, business, a short stay, and you don't have time to rush again to like a supermarket or like some shop to buy this extension plug. The second thing that you need to bring with you is a translation book, or if you have a translation app. This is especially for people who don't speak French. They give you the basic translations of a lot of things like medicine, food, water, directions, taxi, money. So from the time you land at the airport, it won't be very easy for you to find people that speak English. Even though personally I feel like everyone I know already speaks English, but I've met people who say that they found it a bit difficult finding anyone who speaks English, even at the hotels where they stayed. The third thing that I will advise you, and I think this one is mostly for Kenyans because I'm a Kenyan, is you need to carry like food supplies. So for example, you can carry your own maize flour, aka unga ugali. You can carry like sausages, tea leaves. I know there are certain things that you can find here in Abidjan that can be found back home, but then there are those key special items you won't really find here, and you want to save yourself some trouble of feeling like maybe homesick. Let's say if you don't get to like the food here, you need something from home. The fourth thing on my list, I will really advise you to change your currency to euros. Even though dollars is highly acceptable here, euros is a more stronger and a stable currency. I had a really weird experience when I was coming here. Since it was my first time leaving Kenya, I didn't think of changing my Kenyan shillings because I thought that you can change your money anywhere just the same way you can change the dollars and euros. So here I was in Abidjan with a lot of money but worth Kenyan shillings, and I had to wait I think a couple of weeks for one Kenyan who was going back to Kenya. I was able to give them my shillings and I got the CFR. The fifth thing on my list would be for you to carry a mosquito repellent. Even though you can find it here like at the pharmacy or supermarket, you might not have the time to actually go look for these things. Abidjan experiences a lot of humidity and heat, and at times during the night there can be mosquitoes depending on where you live, especially if you live near the lagoon or depending on the season. So if you really don't want to go into such a hassle, just carry like a pocket friendly mosquito repellent. Also, it can be handy when you're traveling, for those of you who be traveling like I don't know outside Abidjan to like the village areas. Prevention is better than cure. So the sixth item on my list will be clothes. Like I said before, in Abidjan it gets humid and hot. Even during the rainy season, it really doesn't get that cold. So I would suggest that you carry clothes that are like airy and light. Things like linen, cotton, things that can absorb sweat really well, because once you're out in this heat and humidity of Abidjan, you're going to sweat in places you didn't even know you can sweat. For ladies, I would advise you to also just carry like blouses that are made of chiffon, but then remember to add something like a camisole. So this is how I've adapted myself here. I just have like tons of black camisoles that I wear under my chiffon blouses, flowy dresses, maxi dresses, short skirts. For guys, I always feel like I need to like talk to Kenyan men, because obviously that's the only other country I've lived in. Come with shorts, something just above your knees. And I know in Nairobi, like, weren't used to seeing men wearing shorts. I mean, because they can be chilly most part of the year. In Abidjan, it's really okay. So you want to have your loafers, sandals, like something that just screams vacation. I'm not saying you forget your blazers and your suits, because you're going to do that at the office. During the rainy season, have like a pair of boots, because then it rains maybe for about 2 months or something. If you have a car, then go, you are safe. You need to have like maybe one coat or like a sweater, just something light you can wear, because at the restaurants we have the AC, at the offices we use the AC, in most shops, malls, so in these places it gets really cold. Another thing about clothes is, you know, to try and minimize on things like skinny jeans. You're wearing skinny jeans in a really, really hot and humid place. It's so uncomfortable. Maybe have a pair or two for rainy season or going out or at night. But most of the time you won't even need it, unless you also just like wearing skinny jeans and you're doing it for fashion. Last but not least, and this is something that, you know, sometimes you think no one is going to forget, but when you're in a hurry to pack your things, you end up forgetting. And this is the yellow fever card. We all know when you're going to apply for the visa to come to Cote d'Ivoire, you're asked to have a yellow fever card. I remember in August when I was coming at the airport, when we were at immigration, one guy, he had forgotten his yellow fever card. But lucky for him, at the airport, there's a room where you go, and then I think then you can be given the yellow fever shot. You really want to avoid all this inconvenience. So when you're taking your passport, your air ticket, just make sure that your yellow fever card is also among these documents. Okay guys, so that's it from this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope that it has helped you, or that it's going to help you with your coming to Abidjan. If you have any questions or suggestions for topics that you'd like me to cover, just hit me up in the comment section below, or you can also send them to me on my Facebook page. Just DM me anytime. I feel like my Facebook page is the best way I respond to people. So just to wish you once again a happy new year. Until my next video,